A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28th August, on the front page you have questions on RBI's credibility outlandish, says Nirmala. So this is finance minister who is slamming criticism on transfer of surplus to exchequer. So RBI had a significant surplus, unprecedented surplus transferred to the central government. It was 1.76 lakh crore surplus, which came from the central bank, which is going to be helping the government in taking care of its fiscal calculations. So this has been criticized, and finance minister slams criticism on or questions on RBI's credibility. And then you have here how a chartered trainer freight aircraft crashed in Aligarh. So, all six passengers, however, are safe. And this is process begins to free Jammu and Kashmir political leaders in phases. So now Jammu and Kashmir government has initiated a process to release at least 173 incarcerated leaders of the regional political parties, including those from National Conference, People's Conference and People's Democratic Party. So this will happen in phases now. So it has become a union territory now. So the government is the left-wing governor. And central government has direct control over the region. Then you have press council criticizes media curbs in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is regarding Press Council of India, which is an independent body which has to uphold free speech or freedom of media. And Press Council of India, earlier in the Supreme Court on the case of restrictions in Jammu and Kashmir, it had said that media curbs in Jammu and Kashmir or restrictions on free speech in Jammu and Kashmir are reasonable and are acceptable in national interest. So this had resulted in huge criticism of Press Council, and now it has taken a stand and has asked and has criticized the media curbs in Jammu and Kashmir. On page 9 you have Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Himachal top India's child well-being index. So here is the index for child well-being, which has been designed to measure and track children's well-being comprehensively. So this is by a leading organization, an NGO, World Vision India, and a research institute, IFMR lead. So in this study, it's by an NGO, you can see Kerala has topped the chart, while Madhya Pradesh was the worst performing state. You can see Meghalaya, Jharkhand and Madhya Pradesh feature at the bottom. Then below you have 5 million hectares of land set to be rejuvenated. So this is in the context of United Nations conference on combating desertification. So this conference of United Nations is going to take place in New Delhi, and it is going to take place a week later. So now presently the government has announced in that context that India will have 5 million hectares of land rejuvenated. So, you know, here you can see it will be degraded land which will be rejuvenated. So in this UN conference also, over 90 countries will deliberate on ways to combat desertification, and India is committed to rejuvenating 50 lakh hectares of land, that is 5 million hectares. So this will be done from the period 2021 to 2030. And you should know, in India about 29% of the land is considered degraded. And also India has just in January 2019 become part of the Bonn Challenge, which is a global effort to bring 150 million hectares of world's deforested and degraded land into forestation by 2020 and 350 million hectares by 2030. So even at UNFCCC conference in Paris in 2015, India joined the voluntary Bonn Challenge and pledged to bring into restoration 13 million hectares of degraded and deforested land by 2020. So from 2021 to 2030, it is now 5 million hectares. Then below you have new guidelines are in for e-tailers. So this is regarding guidelines for e-commerce firms. So they are aimed at protecting consumers' interests. So these guidelines have been issued and will be becoming mandatory under the Consumer Protection Act. So this has been envisaged now. The guidelines have 14-day deadline to effect refund request, mandate e-tailers to display details of sellers supplying goods and services on their website, and also have a procedure to resolve the consumer complaints. So all these are provisions which will have to be put into effect. And also the companies must protect the personal identifiable information of consumers. They should not directly or indirectly influence the price of goods and services, and also maintain level playing field. On the editorial page, the first editorial is gift from RBI. So this is regarding the huge surplus which RBI has transferred to the central government of 1.76 lakh crores. So this editorial says that the government should put the bonanza to use in a prudent manner now. And the second editorial, state of stasis. So this is regarding how in Karnataka, the BJP government's cabinet formation has been stuck in first gear. So in Karnataka, we saw the coalition government had been brought down, and now BJP is taking claim to form the government. It had poached, members of the legislative assembly from the political parties. Also, many had disqualification charges going against them. You can see 17 MLAs were subsequently disqualified, on charges of defection. So after all that politics, now when BJP has formed the government, it is still having issues with respect to how to have chief minister and deputy chief ministers, how the cabinet formation would take place. That is a huge crisis here now. And then you have the lead article, a monumental litmus test. So this talks about Article 370. It says how the Supreme Court decides the cases around Article 370 will have a deep bearing on democracy. So that is that the case on Article 370 being revoked in Jammu and Kashmir has, from the Constitution of India, has been challenged in the Supreme Court, and now Supreme Court will give its ruling on the matter. And this is remembering a painful past. So this is regarding how the drive to rewrite the history of Second World War also accentuates efforts to dilute the global security system. So this is in the context of how, Soviet Union realized that cooperation with Great Britain and France may have prevented the war, or at least ensured a quick defeat of the aggressors. So this is about the Second World War. Then on OPED page, you have rediscovering development banks. So Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, in the press conference recently on August 23, when a number of measures were announced to boost the economy and financial market sentiments, she had put up an idea of setting up development bank. Now, what is this development bank? You can see. So development banks are financial institutions that provide long-term credit for capital-intensive investments spread over a long period and yielding low rates of returns. So examples of these, of course, urban infrastructure, mining, heavy industries, irrigation systems, etc. So such development banks will have lending taking place at low and stable rates of interest, and they will promote long-term investments. So the idea has been put forth, which is good, but how would it be put into effect is to be looked into. And this is cooking with gas, not wood. So this is regarding Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. So under this Yojana, rural areas, it is said, are still relying on solid fuel. Rural areas which are still relying on solid fuel can be encouraged to use clean fuel, to use gas. So it talks of three ways in which they can be encouraged. So here you can see, first it is written is, there's a change, is need for a change in the attitude of the people. The communication aspect, campaigns, communicating and initiating a campaign for that, because there are such preconceived notions that food cooked on chulha tastes better, it is healthier. So this needs to change. So communication campaign advertisement is important, that food cooked on gas can be as tasty and healthy as food cooked on chulha. Then second, LPG prices in rural areas need to be reduced, because LPG connections are provided, but if the prices are high, then they would not go ahead with buying LPG. They would continue to come to their chulhas. So reducing LPG prices is second initiative which is required. And finally, you can see it's written here that it should be made to understand that food cooked on chulhas, you know, under Ujwala, which focuses on benefits of clean fuels for women and reinforcing the inequalities, should also advertise showing that cooking on chulhas is good for men as well. Because in some places, houses, if men cook, then they are not being targeted by the Ujwala scheme. So that aspect also has to be taken into consideration. And it says this will also challenge both misinformation on LPG and gender inequalities in household tasks. And now here you have everyday voyeurism is in a surveillance state. So it is said privacy is a threat as data gathered from CCTV cameras in cities are being shared online. So how data from CCTV cameras, you know, across the country, across the cities in the country are, you know, increasing voyeurism. That means watching other people's actions, so enjoying other people's actions. So social media is hungry for such videos, and you know, lax ethical standards have resulted in such voyeurism from data gathered from CCTV cameras which are shared online. So such video footages are shared. Then on page 12 you have US religious panel anxious about potential abuse of NRC. So US federal government bipartisan commission that looks into matters of international religious freedom have said it is concerned about the finalization of NRC exercise in Assam, the National Register of Citizens Updation exercise. So this is US Commission on International Religious Freedom. So this process of NRC updation could result in stateless Muslim communities is the concern which they have highlighted. On international page you have Communist Party mobilizes against Hong Kong protests. So now pro-China groups are organizing counter campaigns in city which stop violence slogan. So here you can see one such campaign going on here. And this is Brazil open to G7 Amazon aid if Macron withdraws insult. So Brazilian President Jair Bolsonaro has said that he is open to discussing G7 aid for fighting fires in the Amazon if his French counterpart withdraws insults made against him. So there have been such exchange of harsh words between the two leaders of Brazil and France. France is in news because G7 summit is being held in France presently. Then below you have J&J ordered to pay $572 million for opioid addiction crisis. So this is regarding case going on in USA. So Johnson & Johnson, which is a US healthcare giant company, has been ordered to pay $572 million in damages for its role in fostering the state's opioid addiction crisis. So this is the first civil trial of a drug maker over an epidemic that has caused hundreds and thousands of overdose deaths. So this is the case you can see. So it was Janssen Pharmaceuticals, which is a division of J&J, which is going to fund this abatement plan for care of addicts. So these, you know, families and communities were ravaged by this opioid addiction crisis. Then on business page, you have review capital framework every 5 years. So this is Vimal Jalan committee, which had been set up to review RBI's economic capital framework, has suggested that the framework must be periodically reviewed after every 5 years. It has also called for aligning RBI's accounting and financial years to cut need for paying interim dividend too. So the RBI's accounting year and financial year is not the same. You should know that RBI, its accounting year begins in July. And the financial year begins, as we know, from 1st April. So this needs to be aligned as such, which is also a suggestion given by the Vimal Jalan committee. Then on page 17, you have high taxes leading to domestic LPG diversion. So this is an issue which has been brought to the notice of the finance minister that the current manner in which auto LPG is being taxed under GST regime is creating an incentive for people to illegally use domestic LPG as auto fuel. So domestic LPG is taxed at 5% and auto LPG is levied at 18%. So this is leading to diversion of domestic LPG for use as gas to power vehicles. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. Thank you.